Carnby never thought he'd be so happy to be back at Derceto.
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that Dick fella?
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, not good.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't need to know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Carnby seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
The two.
Christ, what the hell was that? I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them. I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office, though. Blocked. It's blocked.
Lunacy in the Astarte Artist Colony, a monograph by Yael Klein. In early 1909, the old Derceto plantation.
Hmm.
Detective Carnby. Good to see you again. Solved the case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink, we pay tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer, thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
Better hold on to these. Wouldn't want them to get lost.
Jeremy knew that the only one who could help him now was the guest in room number 3. The room seemed to have been empty for so long, but that wasn't allowed.
I don't think I have everything I need. There's something missing.
McCarthy was a deadbeat. His mere presence annoyed Carnby. It was like watching the worst version of himself.
Detective Carnby, I'm terribly sorry that my niece has pulled you into this.
Brother, I need you to trust me. This is the most important moment in our family's history.
Recognize this view. I belong here. I know that number. Where's that from? I did this. I wrote that.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case. The child we want is...
How long have I been here? Surprisingly neat. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short.
Sometimes I think this...
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here?
Oh.
place looks familiar. How am I back at the office? Jeremy's never been here. That's a me. Isn't it? How long had it been since I drowned myself in drink and depression? It had all felt so. I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so. Thornhill wasn't a bad man, but he had principles keeping him from handing out information about his deals. So he needed some convincing. Well, every case can't be squeaky clean. Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all, but I can't say it didn't happen.
Thank you.
can't go that way. On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up. I owed them money, a lot of it. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. Just stupid move. They'd be back. Found. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Strike. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room. Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. This room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them. Where? That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge. Pearl River. This is where I caught up with him. This is what the dark man wanted me to revisit. But I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting? I can't believe I didn't recognize you.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just... so much is happening. I can't... I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean... I am sorry. I don't think I need to begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt.
Maybe acceptance. It's what the Dark Man wants.
I guess we just watch my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself. I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes. There was a boat at the house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car. This must be where the bridge is operated. Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
Thank you. Been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place, it's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Derceto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain... things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily? Don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
Something missing. I'm not going in there. She's clearly had enough of me.
need the key. Locked. I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them. I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office then.
I can't leave. I got a job to do.
There must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office in here somewhere. Combination for this. But maybe Jeremy did. It worked.
The last guest in the empty room suffered from severe maladaption.
Dr. Gray's office, all to myself.
I have finished tidying up Miss Beauregard's belongings. I will leave it to you to
figure this guy out.
This is where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young. It's very important.
Dearest Dr. Manzetti, I find myself in a losing battle with my patient. As I've disclosed in my previous letter, his delusions have him completely captured. It's bad enough that he is
take this much more. This has to end.
Thank you.
I need the key.
Radiography, patient Jeremy Hartwood, date June 14, 1930. Hypothetical psychosurgery based on the ideas by Burkhart and the Saint.
Mind if I do? That's better.
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do?
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place.
Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking me.
Jeremy, where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running. It's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river. Jeremy, where are you? Pretty weak. I just... This definitely needs fuel.
described earlier. Are you ready to tell me what happened in the attic? I put a rope around my neck, and then I strangled all life from my body. Are you under the impression? Yes. No. I was supposed to die.
What does that mean?
That you were supposed to die. I'm the catalyst. I had to die to make the story happen.
What are you referring to?
30 years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Find your focus.
Hey! I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
Hey! I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Carnby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
That was Jeremy's self-deceit? A steamboat stuck in the mud? I'm not going to pretend I understand any of that. What a bunch of psychoanalytic nonsense.
Jeremy was...
Detective, am I glad to see you. Lock the door, will you? I don't think Dr. Gray would appreciate us snooping around.
What's going on here? This feels so strange.
Have you found anything?
What? Yeah. Yeah, I've seen some things.
Okay. Let me know if there is anything you want to talk about.
Huh? You don't find this place strange?
Derceto is certainly one of the stranger places I've been to.
There's a book missing.
What did you do?
I was just rearranging the books.
Well, come on, let's check it out. I'm beginning to understand. Dr. Gray is dealing with some kind of mass delusion.
Good to finally meet you, Mr. Hartwood. I'm here on the behalf of your brother, Philip. You were expecting me, weren't you?
Yes. You're from this...
That mark on the floor looks like talisman positions, but from which direction should I look at it?
The Snake Dagger, a monograph by Yael Klein. In Ludwig Prynne's book on pagan rituals called The Mystery of the Grave, as translated by Nicholas Vahey,
what were you saying about mass delusion?
Derceto seems to have a deranging effect on people living close by. It has a history of creating cults devoted to some nature goddess. Even the name Derceto refers to the cult existing here before the Civil War. Derceto was the name of an ancient fertility goddess worshipped in Syria. Dr. Gray and his friends, however, seem to prefer the black goat of the woods with a thousand young, or Shubnigroth. And that name can only have come from my uncle's twisted mind.
Has that been there this whole time? Hello?
Detective Carnby?
Who is this? Jeremy?
Jeremy is with the Dark Man. You can't save him.
Well, I've done everything he wanted so far, and there's just one more thing on the list. I expect him to keep his promise and return Jeremy unharmed.
Get out, Detective. While you still can.
You okay? You look a little frazzled.
Just stupid telephone.
I know. I tried calling the police earlier. The telephone is completely dead.
It's not... Yeah, no, the telephone isn't working. Miss Hartwood, I think you're gonna wanna see this.
Is there something in the closet?
Yeah, there is. You don't see the very obvious gate leading to...
whatever Jeremy's madness is serving up next?
I don't understand. Are you making some kind of fashion metaphor? I'm sorry, I don't have time for this. Can you just tell me what you're doing?
You don't see this. It's fine. It's fine. Catch you later.
Are you going inside the closet?
Yeah. You got a problem with that?
No. Do what you think is right, Detective.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. Goodbye, Miss Hartwood.
Found the ancient stellarium perched on a cliff facing the Arctic Ocean after a day of sailing due north of the Eskimo encampment. Jacob van Ostadt was our most keen member of the expedition. He had been chasing down the source of a peculiar type of crystal. Thank you.
Hey, you! What are you doing here? What is this place?
Turn back, detective. You're not wanted here.
Whoa, take it easy. I'm not your enemy.
Oh, you're wrong, detective. You're wrong.
You wouldn't want your stars aligned, Jeremy, or maybe that is what you need, to temper that mania of yours.
Everything! Aren't you happy?
Stupid.
stupid charlatan. What more do you want from me? You want me to lose my mind?
Oh, my love! Doctor! Baptiste! Quick!
Jesus. What were you thinking, Carnby?
Awake? You are awake. Mr. Conby's up.
Hey, buddy. I thought you'd be knocked out for the rest of the night. Come on out and join us, will you? I'll save you some gumbo.
Good to have you back. You gave us all a good scare.
What happened?
You had a psychological breakdown. Sorry for manhandling you, but you're being violent.
You stabbed Jeremy. And then punch Dr. Gray.
Are they okay?
Jeremy's a little strange, but everything's back to normal.
Really?
All thanks to you, Carnby. You want to try standing up?
Well, if it isn't the hero of the day. How are you feeling, Detective?
Never better. How about you two? Hey, Jeremy, I didn't do too much damage, did I?
Things are fine. Very quiet.
What's up with him? Painkillers?
No. You see, despite you having the finesse of a one-eyed butcher, you managed to lobotomize, dear Jeremy.
I did what?
It's actually quite impressive. It's not like I hadn't considered it myself. I just wish Jeremy could have been helped without reducing his personality to that of an oyster.
But he's gonna live.
Of course. As long as someone keeps feeding him, he'll outlive the best of us.
Hey, Ruth. Glad to see you made it back to Derceto.
You too, Detective. Make sure to stay for the festivities. It's no Mardi Gras, but it ain't bad.
See you back on your feet, Detective. Have some gumbo.
Thanks. I'll save it for later.
Everyone knows what to do? Y'all know the new words.
Mrs. Thompson, we talked about this. I'm not sure everyone is comfortable.
Doctor, I insist. This is important. We've waited for so long, Doctor.
Let's just go with the old song. Not every change is an improvement.
Boss, good or bad, we need to move forward.
All in, Doc. Let's bet it all. But we don't know what we're dealing with.
It'll be okay, Doctor. Better even.
Thank you.
deliver their praises in abundance to the black goat of the woods. Hear us, brother. Take pity on us. Take pity on us.
Stop! Are you crazy?
Yes, please, the helmet costume.
Grace! Stop!
Yeah! Hold on the ground! Yeah! Shoot the ground! The black blow of the water slides!
Stop in the ground! Yeah! Stop in the ground!
Detective, get my uncle out of here!
Jeremy! Come with me! Get over here! Jeremy, come with... Jeremy, come here!
No! There has to be an afterbirth!
We're doomed!
I can't let that monster leave Derceto. I have to stop it.
Detective! Oh,
what the hell was that?
I try to tell you. There was so much evidence. Their devotion to the Black Goat was like nothing I've ever seen before. I felt so dumb believing any of it, but I'm glad I did.
Are you okay?
Everything is out of order. This isn't the way the story goes. I shouldn't be alive.
Yeah. Oh, you're welcome, buddy.
How are you doing, sweetie?
I kinda like it. You ruined everything, but I'm not mad.
All right, you ready to head back to New Orleans?
Come on, Jeremy. We're leaving.
Can I come?
I thought you said you didn't need saving.
Don't leave her. She's important.
Of course we're taking her with us.